Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Monday. It is Monday today. It is time for our market outlook video, looking at this week and what's going to be going on in FIFA Ultimate Team, especially in terms of the market. So, extended weekend league this weekend. As you're watching this, you probably still have a little bit of time to play your weekend league games. You still have the rest of today to finish it, the extra hours and the extra time because of all that. So, that could really affect some of our Monday outlook and the market talk, but a lot of the stuff that I'm going to talk about doesn't really have to do with any weekend league sell-off, although you will see some prices continue to drop down overall across the market on the usable weekend league meta players, just because people are selling off their teams. They had the extra day to complete weekend league, and if they haven't sold already, they probably are. But last night, we got the new Player of the Year SBCs and Young Player of the Year SBC for Van Dijk and Sterling. Now, I wouldn't recommend doing the Sterling card. It's way too expensive, 1.2 million coins. A lot of people are just not even touching that card. If you want to try them out, the loans are cheap. They're 20K a piece and you get 20 games with them. They're really cheap to try out. I would definitely recommend doing that. It costs you like an 83 rated squad for each of those Player of the Year SBC items to do the loan. 100% worth it just to try out the card. But this card right here, and this is the one that everybody's talking about, and this is the one that everybody is doing. As you see up there in the top right, you can barely see it, 13 days remaining. Now, we'll look forward here for just a second. People have seen that this is out for 13 days, and that is making people think that we are going to get Team of the Season starting in 13 days. Now, obviously, there's a community TOTS. There's some voting involved, at least in years past. But maybe that will start in 7 days. But in 13 days, that seems to be when we will be getting Team of the Season, because these SBCs are usually out before Team of the Season actually comes. So that's one thing to keep in mind. But back to this SBC, the Van Dijk SBC is very affordable. We're going to call it affordable, or good value, as people like to say now. This SBC is a pretty good value for the SBC. Basically, you're getting a card that is better than the Team of the Year, plus two in the most, you know, it's got plus two pace, plus one shooting, I think plus one or two passing, but it's got 99 physical and 97 defense. This is the best card that Van Dijk will get throughout the year, and it costs you right now about just over a million coins on either console. You see here, Player of the Year turning in about 1.1 on PS and about 1.08 on Xbox. Now, a lot of people are going and doing this SBC because you get pretty good packs back as well. I mean, you're getting a 100k pack, a 50k pack, a rare mega, and like a prime Electrum or prime players pack. So that SBC is honestly a pretty good SBC. And what we talked about yesterday with some of the investments, I told you guys to get out of your special Sterlings, and I haven't even looked at special Van Dijks yet, but they were not required for either of these SBCs. So a lot of those have tanked, and oh my goodness, 250k. This card's down like 60, 70,000 coins, 240, 230. A lot of people taking some L's. I bet this is gonna hit 200k flat at one point. The panic selling is kind of still going on from this SBC being released. Same thing with this 89 rated inform Van Dijk. Wow, really cheap down here, like 250,000 coins. Same thing with Sterling. I hope you guys sold those informs in the hype, because when you're messing around with a big time requirement like that, like the special card of the player, it's way better to sell in the hype than it is to actually hold, take your guaranteed profit instead of risking it all. Like, this Sterling card's 100,000 coins right now, and he was 160, 170 this last week leading up to the SBC. It's a crazy drop in price for this card. You saw there 102,000 coins, and look how many listers there are. There's people that are panic selling, trying to get out of that investment. Now, a lot of Sterling's cards have dropped, and I'm kind of interested in the right wing cards, especially this cheapest one, and then his most expensive one that is not the SBC, and that's the 92. Still, because Sterling is one of the better, and there's not that many options for right wingers in the Prem, especially with people using cheaper teams right now. Getting the cheapest one, the Inform Sterling that is the 88, I believe, that's something that I'm possibly looking at, and just this Sterling as well, because it's a new card, and if people want to use Sterling, they're probably going to go out and use this one and spend 400k on this card instead of going and paying 1.2 million. or the SBC, but a lot of stuff was panic sold today. How much is it going to rebound? That's the big question for this week, and that's kind of the main point that I want to talk about in this market outlook video this week. What are people going to be doing this week on FIFA Ultimate Team? And basically, your answer to the question is right here in the SBC section. We have the Player of the Year SBCs. We have the new foot swap. Everybody just was able to get their 14th foot swap today. I only had five, so I turned it in for Timo Werner. But a lot of people got this base icon pack. And already, you can start to see a rise in the prices of the higher rated gold cards. 86, there's Verratti, Ozil, all the minimum 86s are up to 20k. The 85s haven't moved much. But for VVD and Sterling, you needed a lot of 87 rated squads. I think VVD actually requires 387 rated squads. So you're seeing a lot of the higher rated players go back up again, which makes sense, along with some of this demand being from icon SBCs that people are now going to be doing from their base icon pack. Now, I've seen a lot of people on Twitter. I mean, if you got something sick, tell me down below, because I've seen a lot of Ronaldos. I've seen a couple Hullets, a couple Ronaldinhos as well. But a lot of people are not going to get a good icon out of this, so they're going to go over here to the icon section, pick an icon that they want to start working towards and building on, and they're going to dump that player into that icon. So probably a Hullet, maybe a Pele, a Ronaldo, a Cruyff. You know, a lot of people are going to start working on an icon SBC this week because they got that foot swap item. And the golds are still pretty low. Oh, what do we get here for a sale? Who sold for us now? Nice. Kolasinac for 38K. That's a nice sale right there. It's a big time sale. But a lot of these golds are going to continue to rise up through the week as people do icon SBCs, as people do the Player of the Year SBC. You're going to see some continued demand for some of those cards. And Otamendi down here at 21K. A lot of people were invested in this card. And it was like 25K right when the SBC came out tonight. It jumped up, and I sold one for 25, and then I stopped myself. I still have some on the transfer list, but I am almost tempted to go out and maybe try to pick up a couple more, because I really think people are going to just do the SBC throughout the week. Now, you don't need a Man City player, but you need Premier League players, and you need chemistry for the Van Dijk SBC, so that's why I'm interested in Otamendi. If I can get him for, you know, 20, under 20K, is I think if I can snipe a couple there, that would be a decent buy for me. I could see this rising back to 25 in the middle throughout the rest of this week. We shouldn't have lightning rounds or a lot of packs opened, but a lot of people should be completing this SBC. That's how I see it, at least. So this week is honestly just going to be another down week. I don't think we're going to get team of the season like a lot of people were initially thinking. So that kind of puts people in a position where they kind of have nothing to do. And when people have nothing to do, like we talked about before, they go and do SBCs, they kind of shy away from the game, or they just go and try players out. And we had some new Man of the Matches this week, especially this Poulsen card, which is gaining a lot of traction and a lot of popularity. He got some supply tonight from marquee matchups. I'm looking to see if I can get him around 150,000 coins. I mean, this card is ridiculously nasty, and there's a lot of hype around him right now. So I see this card as an opportunity. If I can see him drop down a little bit more, maybe snatch one up tonight, he could rise back up to extinct again on both consoles. I know on PS during squad battles tonight, I think he hit like 150 or close to it. So that's an interesting card for me. People are going to be trying cards this week, not really cards that are super expensive that they have to drop a lot of coins on, but just cards that they can, you know, try out in this kind of limbo week of FIFA, as we're in between promotion and the biggest promotion that we've been looking for during this the second half of the year of FIFA, and that is Team of the Season. There's also Champions League games going on this week. Spurs, Ajax, Liverpool, Barcelona. Those are going to be some games you're going to want to watch. They could put out again the UCL Premium SBC and the UCL Upgrade SBC. Those are possibilities that we could see this week as well. So if you have any of those UCL rare cards still in your transfer list from the last time we got UCL supply, you might see a rise in those this week. I think I have a couple here kind of invested for the UCL Premium SBC. that could come back this week. If EA is really trying to suck coins off this market, they could do that again this week in kind of a limbo week where they know they're kind of just stretching out the time and making people wait and building up the suspense for team of the season. And I think a lot of people sold their teams, got liquid for team of the season a little bit too early. So I'm interested to see with the VVD SBC, with the Sterling SBC, this week, if people are going out and doing this, which I think they are, and you're also going to see, this is an also a point I want to make, when you see Van Dijk and Sterling get their player images with, of them holding the trophy, whatever image EA chooses to upload, you're going to see an extra uptick in the people that are going to do this SBC, especially once it gets a dynamic image, just because it looks a lot cooler, and that'll convince more people to actually do the SBC. Now, if you still have informs like I do that you have invested, have some in the club, maybe some gold cards as well, hold on to them. List them for lazies. You see, I have my Otamendi's here listed for 32,000 coins. Definitely overpriced. I do have some inform Jagielkas, an inform Gale or two. Those types of cards, list them for lazies. They're going to continue to rise throughout the week as people go and do the SBC. For VVD, which I think is a pretty good value. Honestly, it's going to be his best card that he gets in the game. He will have a team of the season that comes out, but that card, the team of the season, probably isn't going to be out for another 3 weeks. And in that time frame, wow, this VVD card has risen right back up from where it came. It was just over a million, went down to like 920. Now it's back up to a million coins almost. So, but that 96 VVD is going to be the same as his team of the season. And if you can't wait for the team this season, which might be in 3 to 4 weeks, going and getting this card, I think is a pretty solid deal. You get the good packs back, and you get the best version of Van Dijk, the Player of the Year version. I think this is a pretty good value SBC. A lot of people are going to do it. I am tempted to do it, but I would just rather take my chance, and if I really want to use him, I can buy his team of the season in a few weeks, and maybe pay less for that than I would have to do this SBC for, because if I do this SBC, I feel like I have to, I'm locked and loaded with him for the rest of the game, and unless I get a left back Robertson to use in my end game team, I don't know how I would link VVD. I have Cannavaro at center back, and I have Cancelo at right back, who I would like to use to link to a Ronaldo at center mid. So I don't really know if this works for me. I'll kind of have to use the 14 days time to really think about that and decipher if I want to go after the VVD. But other than that, if you're looking to make coins this week, focus on the rare cards. Links to VVD should rise up a little bit. I know a lot of people have been looking at Dutch icons like a Hullet, the baby Hullet, maybe a Van der Sar or a Rijkaard. That's a popular move. But even like this Future Stars Alexander Arnold. Could be a card that it's pretty rare, so it has the opportunity to rise in the hype at some point in this week. So that's something to keep your eyes on, to keep watch for. And of course, watch the panic selling on these cards. I was a little bit scared, a little bit skeptical, I would say. Not scared, but just skeptical to invest in some of these panic sold cards just because I didn't think the market was going to rebound, but after seeing how long these SBCs are out, I definitely think we're going to see some sort of market rebound, especially this week when there's not too much to do other than do SBCs, and Team of the Season doesn't seem to be on our front doorstep just yet. So again, this week's going to be a week full of SBCs, and when Thursday rewards come, it probably is going to be another great week for flipping the 150 to 300 to 400k items in this game, as people are still playing with cheaper teams, waiting for team of the season to come. Now again, like I said earlier, we're going to be taking a look at a lot of the ins and outs of team of the season. We're going to be taking a look at the high rated gold cards. We're going to be taking a look at what team of the years did last year during team of the season. There's going to be a lot more informational and about team of the season uploads here in the next week or so. I'll probably start to space those out just because I don't think team of the season is going to be really, really soon. So I'll probably space those out throughout this week, maybe into next week as well, until we actually start to hear some concrete things about team of the season. But again, if you got squad battle rewards tonight and you got a base icon pack, let me know what you got. I'm pumped for you guys. If you get the sick pulls, we get another sale. What are we saying? Who is it now? Am I selling these Colossus Match cards for 30,000 coins? 35K. That was an open bid. We'll take that, 35K. I bought a lot of those Colossus Match cards for around 25 to 28K when he was in packs. The Team of the Group Stage cards have actually risen very well out of packs. Good luck on your last day of Weekend League as well. But again, this week on the market, it's just going to be full of this VVD SBC. You're going to see people probably doing squad builders with it, people figuring out whether they want to do it or not. And when people have time to think about an SBC and it sits there long enough in front of them, a lot of times they go and do it. That really influences people to go and do the SBC, especially when it's a pretty good card and pretty good packs back for the value. Let's refresh again one more time. 1.05 million. If you're going to do it, I would do it earlier on as well. I think it's going to keep rising in cost with the gold cards going up, with the inform requirements getting more rare. Take a look at the VVD SBC if you're interested and pull the trigger if you think you're going to have that card, if you want that card in your endgame team for the rest of this year. But that's this week's market outlook. If you enjoyed the video, smash a thumbs up on it, comment down below if you have questions, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. Catch you guys later. Peace out.